But the Bible tells us he came a little bit late, but our Lord is never late. Because the Bible says he makes everything beautiful at his own time. Hallelujah. So the time of the Lord, when he came, he gave a word. And the word was, your brother will rise again. So even you right now, the word that we have from the Lord is that you are going to rise again. Your situation is going to change. You are going to rise and see the glory of God. Because the Bible tells us that in this year, the message that you are given, the word that you are given for this year, the word of the Lord, that it is a year of redeeming the wells for the manifestation of the glory of God. So that is the word that we are standing upon, that God is going to manifest his glory, even as he did for Martha and Mary in this particular year. Hallelujah. Amen. So just be encouraged that you will rise again. And it is God that is raising you up. When we look at the situation around, there was hopelessness. In fact, Mary was very far away from Martha, weeping. And Jesus, when he came, he also assents to the situation, because the Bible tells us he wept. He looked at the situation and he had compassionate. He had love and he wept, looking at the situation. So the situation was not very good, but we thank God because he gave a word, and that word came to be. And the word was, your brother will rise again. And the word I have today is that your situation will rise again. Hallelujah. Yes, it looks like you have lost. It looks like it is desperate. It looks like it is hopelessness. It looks like things are not working out, but the Lord is saying, you will rise again. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. We are rising again by the power of God. In trials, there are normally voices. Mary and Martha were hearing voices. And these voices were not positive voices before the Lord came in. Most of them were negative voices. The loss was too much. In fact, others were saying, if the Lord that was his friend was there, then he could have not passed on. So the voices that were there were negative. So normally what happens is, when we are in trials, the voices may be negative. The voices may be negative. But the Lord comes with a voice. And the voice of the Lord is that you are rising again. The voice of the Lord is that there is hope in your situation. The voice of the Lord is that there is life. The voice of the Lord is that there is lifting. The voice of the Lord is that there is restoration. Hallelujah. We see in the life of many, I think Martha, if you can take us to verse 22, there was an element of faith. And Martha said in verse 22, but I know that even now, God will give you whatever you ask. Yes, the situation was desperate, but there was faith in the heart of Martha. And Martha knew who Jesus was. Martha had seen what Jesus could do. And Martha saying, I know, yes, the situation looks bad, but I know even now, when you come in, even now, whatever you will ask the Father will give to you. So in this time, we are supposed to increase our faith in the midst of these voices that are coming out, in the midst of this desperation and hopelessness that is coming around, we are supposed to lift up our faith. The Bible tells us in Hebrews 11:1, talking about faith. Faith is the substance of things hoped for. What we are hoping for. We are hoping for the glory of God. We are hoping for revival. That is what we are hoping for. So we are supposed to have faith that God is going to do it. Hallelujah. The Bible tells us in the book of Job 22, verse 28. You can take us to Job 22, verse 28.
What you decide on will be done. Light will shine on your wings. 29. Verse 29. When men are brought low, and you say, lift them, then we save the downcast. Then you can give us in King James, in King James Version. 29 in King James Version. The Bible says, when men are cast down, then thou shalt say, there is a lifting up, and he shall save the humble person. So at this moment, our faith is supposed to come alive. Because God is telling us, when others who don't have hope in Christ are saying there is casting down, but us who have hope in Christ, who have hope in the life giver, who have hope in the creator of the heavens and the earth, who know how mighty our God is, we are supposed to speak faith. And the Bible says, when you say there is lifting up, let the Lord will do it. Hallelujah. And that is why this morning we are saying there is rising again. There is lifting up again. The situation may not look good, but our God is raising us up in this situation. Hallelujah. Amen. The faith of the woman with the issue of blood in Luke 8, 43 to 48, made her to pursue because she knew that my help is in the Lord. Last Sunday we were being told we are supposed to lift our eyes up unto the Lord. She knew that the help will come from Jesus Christ, and by her faith she pushed on. The situation around people, the multitude around was negative. They were trying to push away, but we thank God because of her faith she pushed on, knowing that the help is only coming from Him. And when He touched the hem of His garment, she received that healing. Hallelujah. Amen. And even us in this time, as we are pushing on by faith, as we are moving on, digging the wells of revival, turning in the presence of God, calling on His name, knowing that He's the only one who has hope for us, knowing that He's the only one who can lift us up, knowing that He's the only one who has a word for us to change our situations. When we move by faith, we shall see the manifestation of the glory of God. Hallelujah. There is revival. Tell your neighbor, there is revival. Hallelujah. What Mary lost, and God, through Christ Jesus, raised them up unto again, was that they received their brother back. Hallelujah. Then for us, what is it that we shall receive in this process that God is raising us up? What is it that God is raising us up to? Number one, God is raising us up to fruitfulness and increase. Genesis 1:28. He is raising us up to fruitfulness. It may not look as if it is fruitfulness, but God is raising us up to fruitfulness. The Bible says, and God blessed them. And God said unto them, be fruitful and multiply, replenish the earth, subdue it, and have dominion over the fish, over the sea, and over the fowl of the air, and over every living thing that moves upon the earth. So that is the plan of God for us. The initial plan of God. And God is raising us back to that initial plan that He has for us. Even in this situation, that is what God is doing. The Bible tells us in Jeremiah 29:11 that the plans that I have for you are good plans. They are not plans of evil. You may see as if things are not right, but the plans of God are good. In Philippians 1:6, the Bible tells us that He who has begun a good work in you will perform it. So God is performing that purpose that He has for us, that we are going to be fruitful, we are going to multiply, we are going to increase, we are going to have dominion, because that is His word. Hallelujah. Amen. So God is raising you to fruitfulness. Tell your neighbor, God is raising you to fruitfulness. Amen. He is increasing your favor. Yes, because that is what he is promising. He is giving you dominion. Hallelujah. Amen. He is giving you authority. He is a good God. He is a loving God. He is a gracious God. He is a faithful God. Whatever he has planned, he will do. Hallelujah. Then number two, God is raising us to a spacious place. A place of peace. A place of rest. Physically and spiritually. Brethren, in the book of Hebrews, talks about getting to the rest of God. It is a beautiful place, a spacious place, a place of rest that the Lord has told us and is raising us to in this year. Genesis 26, verse 22. Genesis 26, verse 22. What the Lord says, this was Isaac, he digging the wells. The Bible says, he removed from thence and did another well, and for that they strove not, and he called the name Rehoboth, and he said, for now the Lord has made room for us, and we shall be fruitful in the land. Hallelujah. So God is making room for us. It may look as if the room is being made small, but God is expanding us. Hallelujah. God is taking us to a spacious place. A place of peace. He's taking us to our Rehoboth. Because when Isaac died, the words, that is what he received from the Lord. And when we read in this message of the year, the beginning of the words, in verse, I think 17, he went down into the valley. And in the valley, he was redigging the words. He did not give up. He continued by faith. There was potential that he continued by faith. He never gave up until God gave him rest. Hallelujah. So I'm here to encourage you. Don't give up, my brother. Don't give up, my sister. Continue repeating the word, because our God is faithful. He's taking you to a spacious place in the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. And even if you read 20, verse 23 to 24, after that, he rose up. After that, God rose him up. He walked out of the valley. Even you, you are going to walk out of the valley. And the well that he dug after that, there was no contention. Hallelujah. What you are going to dig after this, there shall be no contention, because our God is giving us rest in the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Amen. Number three, God is raising us to a place of restoration. I know we are lost. There are people who have lost jobs. There are people who have lost business opportunities. But the word of the Lord is He's raising us up again. Hallelujah. He's restoring that which we have lost. According to Joel 2, verse 25 to 26. Maybe you can read that. Joel 2, verse 25 to 26. The Bible says, and I will restore to you the years that the locust has eaten, the cacawam and the caterpillars, the palmerworm and my great army which I sent among you. Verse 26. And you shall eat in plenty and be satisfied, and praise the name of the Lord your God that has dealt wondrously with you. So the Bible is that is telling us that we shall eat in plenty. We shall be satisfied. We shall praise the Lord. He's raising us to a place of worship, to a place of praising God, to a place of lifting up His name again, because He's restoring all that we have lost. Hallelujah. He's restoring our health. He's restoring our economy. Yes, our God is restoring everything that we have lost. Even in the entire world, there has been a lot of loss, but our God is saying, He shall restore. He is a God of restoration. This is a season that God is restoring.
Amen.
It may not look like, but that is what our God is doing.
Amen.
Let us have faith. He's doing that. Hallelujah. Then number four, God is raising us again to the life of Christ. The fullness of Christ. The image of Christ is being formed in us, even in this situation. The Bible says the glory that shall be released after the trial is so great that cannot be compared with the tribulation. God is taking us to a place where our character is being built like Jesus. A place of righteousness, a place of joy, a place of peace, because that is the kingdom of God. Hallelujah. In the book of John 10, verse 10, this is the promise of God. John 10, 10, the Bible says, the thief comes not but for to steal, to kill, and to destroy. But the Lord says, I am come that they may have life, and that they may have life more abundantly. Hallelujah. So Jesus is saying, he's raising us to abundance of him, to abundance that he has for us, the life that he has for us. The enemy may be deceiving by showing us things that are negative, but our Lord is saying his purpose of coming is to take us to that place of the fullness of Christ, the place of the abundance of Christ in our lives. If you had lost it, if there was a little bit of backsliding, I'm here to tell you that God is taking you back to his life. God is taking you back to his character. Hallelujah. God is taking you back to his image, because that is the purpose that the Lord has for us. Then what are we supposed to do? We can see what Mary and Martha did. They called on the Lord. They waited, and the Lord came in. And again, they spoke faith, but they didn't know what God had in store for them. Hallelujah. Then for us, in this situation, what are we supposed to do so that we experience, we maintain this lifting of God, this raising of God, this restoration of God, this life that God has for us, this life of abundance that God has for us? What is it that we are supposed to do? Joshua 1, verse 8. Joshua 1, verse 8. The Bible says, the book of the Lord shall not depart out of thy mouth, but thou shalt meditate therein day and night, that thou mayest observe to do according to all that is written therein. For then thou shalt make thy way prosperous, and then thou shalt have. Hallelujah. So we shall have this when we make the book of the Lord, the word of the Lord. Because in the situation of Martha and Mary, it was the word from the mouth of the Lord that your brother will rise again. And God has a word for each one of us. In every situation that we are in, he is always there with a word for us to take us through. So what we are supposed to do in these circumstances that we are passing through, we are supposed to pray in his word. In the book of Colossians 3:16, we shall not read it. The Bible says, let the word of the Lord dwell in you richly. Hallelujah. This is the time to hear only his voice. When you switch on your television, I remember when all these things started on television, it was negative and it was bringing hopelessness. But when you turn to the word of the Lord, there is hope. Hallelujah. When you return to the word of the Lord, there is life. Hallelujah. When you return to the word of the Lord, there is rising again. So this is the time to tarry in the word of God. Let the word of God be the food that you need. Let the word of God be that which consumes you every now and again. In your family, wherever you are, the Bible tells us in that book of Colossians that you sing psalms and hymns, praises to God, as your heart dwells in the word of God. Hallelujah. Then the Bible tells us, when we do that, then he shall make our ways prosperous. He will raise us. He will lift us when we carry the word of God. Because the word of God is the breath of life. The word of God is the one that cleanses us. The word of the Lord is the one that lifts us. The word of the Lord is the one that encourages us. The word of the Lord is the one that brings healing. The word of the Lord is the one that brings restoration. The word of the Lord is the one that brings fruitfulness. We are supposed to tarry in his word and hear what he's saying. And today he's saying he's raising us up again. Hallelujah. The number two, we are supposed supposed to be in a place of prayer. Every fruitfulness, if you look at the Bible, every increase of God, every turnaround of God has always come from a place of prayer. Hallelujah. If we read in the book of Joel, where we say God says promises later that there will be restoration, first of all, there was prayer. Hallelujah. In the time of Peter, before the Pentecost, they were in one place. They were in one accord. And they were praying, interceding. And then the move of God came in. Hallelujah. So we need to be in the place of prayer. Let us read Jeremiah 33, verse 3. Jeremiah 33, verse 3. And the Bible tells us, call unto me, and I will answer thee, and show thee great and mighty things which thou knowest not. So there are great and mighty things that God is doing that we do not know. But he's saying, if we call on him, if we tarry in the place of prayer, then he will open our eyes. And we will see the great. We will have the hope. We will see the mighty things that he has in store for us. And if we read the same book down there, verse 6, there was a restoration for the children of Israel. Hallelujah. When we tarried in the presence of God. Philippians 4, verse 6. Philippians 4, verse 6 also tells us that we are not supposed to be anxious. We are not supposed to be worried. Do not be anxious of anything, but in everything, by prayer and petition, make your requests be made known to God. And now that it says, and the peace of God that surpasses all human understanding shall fill your hearts. Hallelujah. Amen. Then the last thing that we need to do is repentance. We are supposed to repent. We are supposed to turn back to him. The Bible tells us in the book of 2 Chronicles 7:14. This is a verse that we know so much, and it applies even right now. The Bible says, if my people who are called by my name shall humble themselves and turn back to God, then God promises that he shall forgive, he will forgive them their sins, and he shall bring restoration. He will heal the land. Hallelujah. Joel 2:12. You may read that as we conclude. Joel 2:12. The Bible says, even now declares the Lord, return to me with all your heart, with fasting and weeping and mourning. 13. Rent your hearts and not your garments. Return to the Lord your God, for he is gracious and compassionate, slow to anger and abounding in love, and he relents from sending. He forgives, he relents. Hallelujah. Verse 14. Who knows? He may turn and have pity and leave behind a blessing, a grain offering, a drink offering for the Lord your God. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. So the Lord is telling us we're supposed to repent. We are supposed to return back to him. Yes. And he's saying, not just our garments, but our hearts. Yes. That we are supposed to bring our hearts to him. We are supposed to return to our God. So I know we have people who are viewing, and also those who are with us in the auditorium. I'll give you an opportunity. If you want to give your life to Jesus Christ, this life giver, the Savior that we have for us, that is promising, raising again, that is promising restoration, that is promising lifting. It starts by you repenting and returning to the Lord. So if you want to give your life to Jesus, we can just pray together with you. So let us believe and pray. So you will say this after me. Lord Jesus, I thank you because you gave your life for me on the cross. Today, I acknowledge that I've been far away from you. I return to you. I ask you to save me. Make me your own.
Lead me in my ways as you raise me up again. In Jesus' name, I pray and I believe. Amen. 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 Hallelujah. There is joy in heaven. And may God bless our brethren who have been watching with us. May God bless you. Have a blessed week. The Lord is raising you up. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen.